So actually, when she board the bus, at that time she was too small, so conductor and the other passengers just make her fun. And the conductor, because conductor offer her help to climb up on the bus, but she refused. So that is why the conductor was just in a funny way, he told to her, "Madam." So all the peoples were laughing and just saying to madam the all the way. So likewise that again and again, when the conductor said the same thing to her, she was feel so awkward at that time. Again, the sarcastic tone, the conductor seeks the approval of madam before beginning the journey, and then both his wrist twist twice on signal the driver to start the bus. The bus was new, as was evident from the overhead silver bars that were shining. There was a clock just in front of valise, and the seats were extremely comfortable. The outside was painted in the glowing white with stripes of the green along the sides. Valley devours everything with her eyes, but when she started to look outside, she found her views cut off by the canvas blinding that covers the lower part of her window. So she stood up on the seat and peered over the blind. So she quickly glanced at the inside of the bus and turned towards the window to have view of the outside, but couldn't have a complete view, for she was too short and the window blinds were obstructing her view. Thus she decided to stand up to be able to look properly, because she came to enjoy the bus journey, and when she's not able to see outside. So what he had done, according to a child of 8 years, she was just to stand on that. The bus was on a very narrow road. On one side there was a canal, and beyond it trees, distant mountains, and the large blue sky could be seen. Whereas on the other hand, there were a greenery all around. Well, he was enjoying a lot when suddenly someone asked her to sit down. While sitting down to see who told her so, she saw an old man showing concern for her, still in no mood for anyone's help or advice. It made Valley annoyed, because she's a child and she was just thinking about that these people are just poking their nose and don't want to be me to enjoy like that. So that is why she just not want to listen. Well, he was too proud to take anyone's help and thus told the old man that she was not a child. She said that she was just like everyone else traveling in the bus and could take care of herself. She had paid the full fare just like everyone else. The conductor made a remark that she is grown up, madam. So because every time he was saying, "Madam, madam," so likewise that. Because a child could never pay for his or her bus ticket, very annoying, told the conductor not to call her madam and reminded him that she has not yet received the ticket. The conductor then responded by mimicking her tone, hereby making everyone laugh. Valley ended up to laugh too. The conductor then handed her the ticket and asked her, "Just sit back and make yourself comfortable. Why should you stand when you have paid for a seat?" To which Valley proudly replied that she do whatever she wants. Actually, she understood that the conductor is making fun of her, so that is why. They further tried to explaining her that they were genuinely concerned about her and she may hurt herself in the continue to stand. Because in the bus is riding at that time, So it will be harmful for a child. She again made it clear that she was 8 years old and hence not a child. The conductor did not leave her chance, this chance to have a good laugh too. The bus stopped and the more passenger boarded the bus, and in order to preserve her seat, she quickly sat down when an old woman sat near her. The lady was staring at Valley before asking her if she was all alone. Valley developed a strong dislike for the lady whose elaborate head being whole. She did not like her earning too, and looking at how she was chewing betel nuts. She was the last person Valley would see the socialize with him. So actually she doesn't like, but the obviously bus is there. Many type of people are coming. So one old lady was seated there. Though annoyed by the eldest lady, Valley replied to her by saying that, yes, she was traveling alone, and that too, with a ticket of her own. Evidently, the conductor spared on the chance to tease Valley and have good laugh. Now Valley laughed with him to while the old days continued to interrupt by asking abrupt Valley's increasing security, and that if she could not reach her destination safely all alone. Valley assured her that so she first traveled alone and started looking outside the window and avoid the further conversation of the people, those who are doing, and try to doing herself to her. Undoubtedly, she had put a numerable amount of efforts in planning and saving of her first ever bus journey. It was a dream ride for her. She resisted every temptation, dragging from the peppermint toys, balloons, or to marigold go around and the village fair. After so many efforts, she finally had 60 paisa, because she required only 60 paisa. One from one side fair is 30. So when the financial obstacles had been deleted, the next problem was to able to sneak out window and even noticing. Usually Valley's mother used to sleep from 1 to 4 every afternoon. Valley used to benefit from this and used to go to excursion in the village. This time it would be use an excursion to outside the village.